While robots have always been associated with metals and ceramics, a team of US scientists are fast changing this narrative. By integrating biology and mechanical design, they have successfully created a new class of robots that are not just living, but are also capable of reproducing. These new hybrid robots are made from living tissue and an artificial scaffold that enables them to move more like living organisms than machines. Quickly and naturally respond to the external stimuli, heal quickly from damage or injuries, and above all, replicate themselves in almost the same fashion that we humans do. To robotics experts, these new robots, otherwise called xenobots, have become the most prominent offshoot of a similarly new field of robotics known as biorobotics or soft robotics. In this video, we've unraveled what these stunning biorobots are and just how they are able to reproduce new replicas of themselves. Xenobots, as they are called, have two main components of skin cells and heart cells, both of which were obtained from the frog, Xenopus lavis, and after which they are named. If you were to observe these organisms under a microscope, you'd see them move swiftly around, moving forward, backwards, and sometimes spinning in a circle. Similarly, if you were to scatter some particles around them, they would round them up and make little piles as if organizing the debris. Their motion and behavior closely resembles that of other microscopic organisms, and they're able to retain even the tiniest piece of information while working together. Unlike other microscopic living organisms, however, these biorobots were not born out of years of evolution. They are rather the product of human design, built using highly advanced computers. Even while still in their early development stages, these xenobots are already redefining the concept of life in ways that science is only just catching up with. And just when the scientists who were responsible for their creation were still marveling at their very unique movement patterns, they made a much more shocking discovery after realizing that these robots were spontaneously making new copies of themselves, creating new types of life forms. Much like classic robots, which are often built with the aim of helping humans to solve cogent life problems, these xenobots are already being hoped by scientists to be capable of this same role despite their microscopic nature, being under 1 millimeter in size. In fact, the expectations are much higher, and a number of biorobotics experts are already predicting that xenobots would be capable of helping us monitor radioactivity, combat pollution, and even help cure diseases in the near future. These xenobots, unlike their classical counterparts, aside possessing more advanced functionalities, are also devoid of the typical shortcomings of regular bots. Due to the fact that they are living organisms, they possess greater flexibility than artificial robots and are able to protect their internal structures by taking in energy from their surroundings. In essence, they're not affected by the rust and the wear and tear of classical bots. In addition to this, these biorobots also have useful lifetimes that far surpass that of the best-known artificial robots. The biological components of these xenobots are not just functioning as actuators, which enable them to move. To the brains behind these biohybrids, there's an entire world of innate behavior and rich biochemistry that could be tapped into using these biological components. The grand idea behind xenobots is essentially to make entirely biological robots with no artificial components. By using only animal cells, and while robotics engineers have always modeled robots after living creatures that exist on our planet in terms of their design, biorobots have taken a rather new dimension, using actual animal cells in creating these xenobots. These robots are entirely built from the ground up with no single artificial component. These xenobots are totally new configurations that were developed using embryo sembryos from the Xenopus lavis, the African clawed frog. After the eggs are fertilized, they become a ball of stem cells and appear in clumps that are completely uniform. While all these cells often independently grow into different components of the xenobot following a natural order, the cells on top often become the epidermis, being key to the development of the robot's central nervous system. The cells in the middle form the core muscles that aid movement by the xenobots, and the cells on the bottom form the endoderm, which is vital for the development of other organs needed by the bot. From further studies, the scientists behind these new robots have likewise discovered that these different sections can be disassembled by hand or using forceps into their different components and reassembled into whole new arrangements. Upon detaching the desired part of the Xenobot, this removed part can then be mushed back elsewhere before bathing the bot in a media that immediately causes them to stick back together. While the formation of the bots is done by human hands, their designs have very little human input as they're largely done by a complex artificial intelligence program called the VoxCAD. This program creates a virtual environment that's complete with real-life simulations and small cubes called voxels, which essentially become the cell for each digital Xenobot. These voxels possess gravity, friction, surface tension, and other real-life elements of liquid physics. Each tube depicts a different real-life cell identity. In the early stages, just two cell types are utilized, usually the cells responsible for skin cell development and the cardiac cells, to enable the Xenobots to possess contractile capabilities from the get-go. In the early stages, the most important objective is usually for the Xenobots to move unidirectionally, usually forward. Once this is achieved, the different cell cubes are then randomly combined by the AI to evolve into digital Xenobots over time, creating iteration after iteration until biorobots display the desired behavior. The final design of the first digital Xenobot had leg-like appendages and could scuttle in a motion-like manner. Upon the perfection of these digital versions, the scientists then return to the lab with the exact configuration, making sure to stick to correct cells together and sculpt it into the right shape. The Xenobots, upon their recreation in the labs, are then subjected to a series of trials, for mostly on multi-directional movement. This is to ensure that they are able to move through varied environments. Xenobots, while moving, often follow the path provided by whatever environment they're in, proving just how quickly adaptive they can become. Should these bots get injured while navigating their environment, their creators likewise found that they're capable to heal up completely from such injuries within 10 minutes. And, with the wounds closing up completely, while scientists worked tirelessly to understand just how this natural healing was possible, it soon became obvious that it was a rather built-in feature that likely accrued from the random mixing of cells by the AI. And just as Xenobots began making waves in the robotics community as the revolutionary biohybrid materials from which these Xenobots were originally made were added into their cubes, they swept up these particles into small piles while infusing them with genetic materials for themselves. And only after a while, these piles of cells turned into new Xenobots themselves. To scientists, what the Xenobots did has never been observed in living organisms or in cellular life forms up until now. It's a new form of biological reproduction different from any animal or plant reproductive process known to science. Now termed kinematic self-replication, scientists are now very hopeful that it could play a crucial role in further explaining the origin of multicellular life on Earth. Presently, Xenobots can live for 10 days in their natural aqueous environment without any need for food from an external source. While this is a good start, it greatly limits what a Xenobot could do in the real world. However, a limitless generation of Xenobots is still possible if they are continuously added to the environment. According to studies, these bots in their large volume can be a force for good, helping to tackle real-life issues like pollution, careful selection of specific cell types for use in regenerative medicine, as well as the aggregation of requisite materials needed to help human bodies replace damaged tissues. Research is now actively ongoing in creating Xenobots that will have a working memory and will be capable of reading and writing. Scientists believe that giving reliable memories to Xenobots would be instrumental to helping us as humans understand and utilize them better. For context, Xenobots can be used in detecting the presence of radioactive compounds and chemical pollutants in drugs, as well as in diagnosing certain disease conditions. Presently, Xenobots merely occupy a space between living organisms and machines, being very simple and lacking nervous systems. In the future, however, these biobots are predicted to be capable of feeling emotions and pain and becoming the driving force behind the next century of technological developments. Xenobots are still very early technology, just like computers in the 1940s, and still do not have any practical application. However, this interesting combination of molecular biology and artificial intelligence, according to the team behind Xenobots, could potentially be used in a host of tasks in the body and the environment.